Good morning, student of 10th class. Today we are going to solve the practice set 3.4. Here we draw the diagram. Question number 1. And fill the information as per given in a example. I will read this. In the figure, in a circle with a center O, length of AB is equal to the radius of the circle. This length of a chord AB is equal to the radius of a circle. Then find measure of each of the following. First, angle AOB. Measure of angle AOB. So, for finding out it, we are taking firstly the segment OA is congruent with segment OB because it is a radius of a same circle. Then chord AB is equal to the radius, means chord AB is equal to the radius, means it is equal to or the congruent with segment AB. This chord AB is same as radius of circle. So we can say that the segment AB means segment AB, AC, OA, these three are of the same length, means they are congruent. Means segment AB is equal to segment OA is equal to segment OB. All are congruent. So this is the equilateral triangle, the angle AOB. The three segments are equal, so angle triangle AOB is a equilateral triangle. Equilateral, I'll write it short. It is a equilateral, means it is having a three sides equal. So their angles are also equal, and the angle of a equilateral triangle, means take any angle. I have taken here AOB. Triangle of a equilateral triangle means any angle of a equilateral triangle is equal to 60 degree, means 180 degree divided by the same. Three angles are the same, so it is a 60 degree. So we will get the value of a AOB. Measurement of the AOB equal to 60 degree. Then second sub question, find the measure of ACB. Here, it is the C point here. So find the measure of ACB. So we are finding about the measure of ACB. This angle is of a 60 degree. It is a central angle. AOB is equal to 60 degree. It is a central angle. And central angle intersect this chord. Okay. This is the intersected chord. And the measurement of an arc. Arc AB is equal to the central angle, means it is equal to the AOB and it is of a 60 degree. Then we want to find this, we will get the chord or the arc measurement of RAB is equal to 60 degree. Then by inscribed angle theorem, what it tells? It tells the inscribed angle. C is the inscribed angle because C is the lies on a point C. And AB is the intersected arc. The inscribed angle theorem tells that it is a half of, means angle ACB is a half of the intersected arc, means measure of arc AC, and measure of arc here is AB, not AC. So 1 half into measure of arc is what? Is it 60 degree? So it will come 30 degree. So we will get the measure of angle ACB is equal to 30 degree. Then the third sub question, of question number 1. Arc AB. We find out that arc AB is equal to what? It is a, by definition of a minor. Arc AB. This side, not this side. Arc AB. Okay, we find out it is equal to the central line. Means, by central angle theorem or the property, the measure of arc AB is equal to the central angle and it is equal to what? 60 degrees. So we will get the measure of arc AB is equal to 60 degrees. So we get the answer of a question. Third sub question, then fourth. What is given in the fourth? Find measure of arc ACB. Measure of arc ACB. Miss this. AB is the arc. It is minor arc. It is a major arc. So we will get the measure of arc. Measure of arc ACB is equal to the total 360. Circle is of 360 minus the minor arc. Therefore, 360 degree. What is the measure of a minor arc AB? Minor arc is a AB. So it is a 60 degree. So we will get it 300 degree. So measure of a arc ACB is equal to 300 degree. So we solve the question number 1. Then the question number 2. Here again we need the diagram. So I will draw the diagram of a circle. And what will be given inside it? This is our circle. Then I will draw the chord, draw the triangles, and read the examples. What will be given in a example? As per given information, we draw the diagram, or the diagram is already given in a question. So this is the point P, yes, R and Q. So I will read the question. In the diagram, PQRS is a cyclic. This quadrilateral PQRS is a cyclic. Side PQ is equal to RQ. Means in a given. Question number 2. PQRS is a cyclic. Means we start the solution of it. What will be given? That will be written in the given. Then side PQ. This side PQ is equal to side RQ. Side PQ is congruent with side RQ. Then angle PSR. Angle PSR is of 110. PSR, this angle 110 10 degree. So first sub question, find the measure of arc PQR. Measure of angle PQR. So PQR, where is the PQR here? PQR. We want to find out the value of our P. So solution is first solution is what? PQRS is a cyclic. PQRS, quadrilateral. PQRS is cyclic. And by using the property of a cyclic quadrilateral, the opposite angles of a quadrilateral. The opposite angles of a quadrilateral are supplementary, means their sum is a 180 degree. Therefore, in cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles are supplementary. Means their sum is a 180 degree. So we are writing the sum of these two. This PSR, measure of angle PSR plus measure of angle PQR is equal to 180 degree. By putting the value of a PSR, that is 110 degree, is equal to 180 degree. So by transforming on that side, the sign will get changed. So 180 degree minus 110 degree. So by subtraction, it will come 70 degree. So PQR is equal to measure of angle. PQR is equal to 70 degree. So we got the first answer of the first sub question. Then, second, in the question number 2, what they are? Second, measure of arc PQR. Measure of arc PQR. Where is the PQR, P, Q and R? This total arc you want to solve. Find out it. Okay. It is a 70 degree. So, again by using the property, measure of a PSR means inscribed angle. PSR. This PSR. Measure of a angle PSR is a half of the intersected arc, means measure of arc PQR. By putting the value, PSR is equal to 110 degree. One half remain as it is, means this side remain as it is. These two gets, this is the divided, so by changing side it will get multiplied. So 110 degree into 2 upon 1 means that is a 2, is equal to measure of R PQR. So 2 into 2, 110, that is a 220 degree. So we will get measure of R PQR is equal to 220 degree. So we solve the second also. Then third sub question. Then the third sub question. Third sub question. For the answer, measure of RQR, measure of RQR. So to find out the measure of the RQR, this one, you want to find out this R. So by using the properties, chord PQ is congruent with chord QR, that is given in the our example. Then, therefore, the intersected arc by that chord is also a congruent. So, arc means arc PQ is congruent with arc QR because of that property. The congruent chord intersect the congruent arc. So, by putting the equation is arc of corresponding congruent arc. That is the reason, so it is, both are the equal. Then, You are considering both as a x, both as a x, consider. If you consider it both as a x, both chords are, both arcs are x. So, by putting the values, means PQ and QR, PQ and QR is the sum of, means their sum is PQ plus QR, that is a PQR, means measure of arc PQR is equal to measure of arc PQ plus measure of arc QR. So by substituting instead of that, that is a x, it is also x, and measure of arc we find out it is a 220 degree. Then we are summing it, x plus x is equal to 2x. And here is a 220 degree. So, 2 gates they are divided. So, value of x is equal to again 110 degree. So, the value of measure of arc means x, x is the arc PQ and arc QR. So, here we want to find out the measure of arc QR, will get this 110 degree. So we solve the third sub-question of question number 2. Both are the equal, so it is considered as the x. So by taking addition and by putting the value of PQR, by transforming these two, we will get x is equal to 110 degree. Then, fourth. Question number 2. Find the measure of arc PRQ. Measure of arc PRQ. PRQ. You want to find out the measure of this arc PRQ. So, for that we are using the property measure of arc PRQ is a half of arc PQ. Means PRQ, this is inscribed angle, intersected by this arc. So by that property or the theorem, inscribed angle is equal to the half of intersected arc. By using inscribed angle theorem, what is the reason? Inscribed angle theorem. So by putting the value, measure of arc PRQ is equal to half of, what is the PQ? We find out it is 110 degree, half of this. So, into 110 degree. So, by dividing it, we will get that it is a 55 degree. This PRQ, measure of angle PRQ is equal to 55 degree. So, we solve the total question number 2. With some questions, then we are going to solve the question number 3. I will read the question number 3. MRPN is a cyclic. Quadrilateral MRPN is a cyclic. Then angle R is given. Angle R is equal to 5x minus 13 degree, and angle N is equal to 4x plus 4 degree. Then find the measure of an angle R, means same angle, and measure of angle N. So solution. By given information, it is a cyclic. Therefore, the sum of R, by using the property of a cyclic, that the opposite angles of quadrilateral, and which is a cyclic, are supplementary, means their sum is a 180 degree. So angle R here in the diagram, M, R, P, M. It is a cyclic. So, the opposite angles, which are the R and L, the sum of measure of R angle R and N is equal to 180 degrees. By putting the value, what is the value of R? That is a 5x minus 13. And what is the value of N? 4x plus 4 is equal to what? 180 degrees. By solving it, this equation, we get here that 5x plus 4x, that is a 9x, minus 13 plus 4, that is a 9, because they are different in a sign, so we are taking subtraction and higher number sign is a minus, so it is a 180 degree. So we are taking the common as a 9, so x minus 1, we are taking 9 as a common, so it is here 1 is remain, is equal to 180 degree. So by transforming on that side, this it will get, it is multiplied here, so it will get divided. So 9 1 is that, 9 2 is that, means here we get 20. So x minus 1 is equal to 20, therefore x is equal to 20 plus 1. So value of x is equal to 21. So we will get the value of x is equal to 21. So we are finding out the values of both angles R and L. So by putting the values, angle R is equal to, what will be given here? Angle R is equal to 5x minus 13 degree. So by putting the value of x, instead of x we are writing 21 here minus 30. 21 into 30 is 105 minus 13. So by subtracting it, we will get the value of R is equal to 92 degree. So angle R is equal to what? 92 degree. Then we are finding out the value of L, angle L. What is the given instead of angle L? 4x plus 4, 4x plus 4 degree, means by putting the value is equal to 4, 84 plus 4, that is also 86 degree, no, it is a 88 degree, means measure of angle L is equal to 88 degree. So we are finding out the value of R and value of L of question number 3. It is so easy to solve. When we know the property, we can solve any type of example. So firstly study the properties. Then question number 4, 5, 6 and 7 and 8. So we are going to solve the question number instead of 4, we are solving the question number 5. Prove that any rectangle is a cyclic quadrilateral. Means, to prove, what is the proof? Any rectangle, is cyclic. We want to prove it, so we are drawing the diagram of a rectangle ABCD. So the common name we have taken here, rectangle ABCD. So given is what? ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is rectangle. And we want to prove it that it is a cyclic, means ABCD. Rectangle ABCD is cyclic. So proof started. Very easiest. Here, by using the property, angles of a rectangle is of a 90. Every angle of a rectangle is a 90 degree by using this property.
ABCD is the rectangle. This rectangle.
This is the given.
So reason is what?
Given. Then angle A, each angle. Angle A, angle B, angle C, and by property of a rectangle. The property of a rectangle. Every angle is of a 90 degree. That is property. Angles of a angle of rectangle. Therefore, we are taking the two angles, opposite angles. Two opposite angles A plus angle C. We want to find out the sum of it. So A is a 90 degree, also C is also 90 degree. So their sum is a 180 degree, and we know that the converse of a, so therefore A, B, C, D is a cyclic. What is the reason? Converse. In a converse, if the opposite angle sum is a 180 degree, then that type of a quadrilateral is a cyclic. So our rectangle, their opposite angle sum is a 180 degree, so it is a cyclic. Converse theorem of a of cyclic quadrilaterals. That is the reason. So we solve the question number 5. Then question number 4, 6, 7, 8. We will solve in the next video. Thank you.